As mentioned previously, a Flex dashboard is basically a Markdown document, just rendered as a dashboard. By changing just a few settings, we can update the entire look and feel of that dashboard. In this video, we're going to be going over what some of those settings and options are. To make this easier, I've created a cheat sheet with all of the available options, which we'll be going through now, and is available as a download as part of the lecture resources. So I've pulled up a copy of our cheat sheet here, flashdashboardcheatsheet.rmd. And on the left here, we have our original Markdown document. So we can look at these side by side at the same time. I'm just going to pop out this window using this button here. So the first thing I wanted to point out here is that Flex dashboards only really look at headers level 1, 2, 3 for layout purposes. Now, you notice on the left over here, we've got headers levels 1, 2, and 3 using one style of Markdown, which is using a number of hashes. And on the right here, we have another Markdown style, which is using these equal signs across the page. You only need three of these, but you can have it longer just to make a nice clean separation. And for level 2, we have a slightly different style as well. All the rest of the levels below 3 and below are still all the same. Now, this is still perfectly valid markup, even if it doesn't look quite as familiar. Flex dashboards will work with both, but often you will see when you're looking at Flex dashboards that this particular convention is used. But again, both the same. Flex dashboards effectively have three types of layouts. We can either have page, column, rows, or tabs, page, rows, columns, or tabs, or storyboard, which uses header level 3 only. So with these two layouts here, page is header level 1, column or row is header level 2, and our content goes into header level 3. All layout options are basically controlled in one of two places. Either up the top here, inside what's known as the YAML header, or as tags next to the different header levels using the curly braces. And this is what they look like here. In this cheat sheet, I've put L1, L2, and these are basically just shorthand for this is a tag that belongs to a level 1 header. The sidebar is a tag that belongs to a level 1 or level 2. And this is a setting that belongs to a header level 3. So let's start with some of the configuration options that we can do inside the YAML header. Now, it's important to note that YAML is very sensitive about spacing. So when I add title here, it's important that I have a space after the colon. Otherwise, this won't work. Also, the indentation. This is also very important. If the indentation is wrong, it also won't work. All of these three options here are optional parameters for Flex dashboard, so you can actually remove all of these. But if you do, make sure to remove this colon here. Otherwise, again, this won't work. So you can see here that we're running Flex dashboards or outputting as Flex dashboards with all of the default options. And just so you know, the default options for these is orientation is equal to columns, vertical layout is equal to fill, and storyboard is equal to false. So let's just quickly take a look to see what that looks like. Control Shift K will render our dashboard. Okay, so this is what we have to start with. Let's have a little play around with to see if we can update a few things. So the first thing that we can add in here is we can go ahead and add a title. So this is the dashboard title. This is something that will actually show up on your dashboard, so handy to have there. If I want to add a few Flex dashboard options, and drop this down here. So the default option is columns, and I can switch this to rows. Let's have a look, see what that looks like now. And you can see how the layout has changed. So one thing that you notice here is that everything fits quite nicely into our window. So there's no scroll bar. Everything has just been resized to fit. And so that is the default option, the next default option here, where vertical layout is equal to fill. This works well if you don't have too many boxes on your screen. If you do have a lot of content, if you have more than a couple of charts stacked on top of each other, then you may want to consider using the scroll layout instead, so that not everything gets crammed in. The other option, of course, is also using pages, which you can define using header level 1. Now, the next option I want to discuss here is storyboard. So, as mentioned, storyboard, the default option is false. So let's set that to true. Now, the reason why this doesn't seem to have done anything is because we still have header items 1 and 2. And storyboards really only work properly with header level 3. So let's quickly set up another little dashboard to see how storyboard works. So let me take this, and I'm going to set up another quick little dashboard over here. Let's save this as storyboard test.rmd. Paste this in here. And header level 3s. This is, say, page 1. Some content. Storyboards have something unique, as when you add this markdown item, which is usually for a horizontal line, we can add some comments here. Page two content. Page 3. So if we render this, this is what the storyboard layout looks like.